Hey everyone, Zonflux here. I'm going to continue on with my list of solo accomplishments. This time I'm going to be recording a solo from the Fornost instance Wraith of Earth. It's a 6-man fellowship tier 1 I'm going to be doing at level 100. So Wraith of Earth, travel now. I seem to remember the most difficult part of this instance when Fornost, I did it before, the last capital of the was actually North one of the optional mini bosses that the Witch King of Angmar crushed the realm of Arnor, anyway. And it is here to which Angmar one thing is important to do the side objectives in these Fornost instances, as they reward around 71 medallions each, which is quite a bit. Usually I like to fight up here at least initially, just because it helps with the ranged attacks, which I find I'm the weakest against. Fairly straightforward fight. Oh yes, the most annoying part about this instance is all of these trolls that throw stones, so you can't really group them up because they don't clump up together and fall. So the killing the trolls is one of the side objectives, and the trebuchets is the other side objective. The foremost instances don't really reward that many skirmish marks, but they do reward good medallions. So, for marks, I mean, you could probably do Sambrog runs, and then for medallions, I would probably do the foremost runs. So you can see behind this guy, that's the first mini boss, and the most difficult thing about him is that it's a DPS race. The longer the fight goes on, the harder he will hit, so you want to burn him down as quickly as possible. He gets these stackable corruptions that can't be removed, and he can hit pretty hard. I'm just gonna go ahead and pop a hope token, more so for the extra damage that I can get to fight this guy. And yeah, other than that, that's about it. Pretty sure you don't want to be fighting this guy for more than a few minutes. And since he's immune to stuns and fellowship maneuvers, you might as well use your charge stun for the brief but useful plus 10% damage boost. As you can see, he's already got his corruption starting to stack quite a bit here. Good idea to try to keep War Chant on if you have that traded, that'll help out a bit. And ouch! Ah, oh, just barely. Yeah, he can hit quite hard at the end there. I mean, I did only get hit for 6,700, but I have pretty high mitigations. I imagine some of you could get hit for anywhere from 10 to 20,000. 21 medallions for that. These guys are annoying the way they split up. I suppose I can spread lead. Haha, no, I didn't. Thought I did. Can't really remember what the end boss fight is like. I think on tier 1 it's kind of a joke. Tier 2, I can't remember what the challenge is, but it probably involves killing the boss before the ads or something like that. That would be my guess. Find my notes. Alright, so you'll see here, this will probably be about 71 medallions. There we go, 71. bounced around all over the place, but once I put the shield on, it's pretty survivable. Main thing is just to get rid of these ranged guys. Miss a lever. That's not the way. I feel like I need to go through. Oh, there we go. Why don't you follow me? I think the end boss is right after this door here. Can't remember anything special about this guy, he just calls a bunch of ads. When you're fighting him, you want to make sure that you don't have common damage. Valerian is what most people use, and Valerian will work just fine. So yeah, I mean, I don't know what the challenge is for this on tier 2, but like I said, it's probably kiting or killing the boss without killing the ads. I mean, otherwise, when you're killing the ads, it's like... There you go. Fornos, Wrath of Fire, tier 1. Loot, bunch of relics. I didn't even get an item actually. Hope you enjoy Zoneflex, Guardian of Brandywine.